themes and color schemes. We'll use them, and in most cases, it doesn't really matter. It's just about what makes the application look good, and whatever that means to you. Now, for some people, of course, there are exceptions when you have, say, a vision issue, where you need a certain kind of theme to compensate, you know, for your vision issues. But when we're talking about programming environments, development environments, code editors, places that you write code, color plays a very different role. Now color actually has a direct function. Color is now syntax highlighting. This is providing a way so that you can find important context in an application without searching the entire document. And recently, this article came by my feed. I'm sorry, but everyone is getting syntax highlighting wrong. And when someone confidently says that everyone else is wrong, I have to hear them out. Christmas lights diarrhea. Most color themes have a unique bright color for literally everything. One for variables, another for language keywords, constants, punctuation, functions, classes, calls, comments, etc. Sometimes it gets so bad that we can't see the base text color. Everything is highlighted. So what's the base text color here? Now, this is a really, really extreme example. But I'm pretty sure that it's based on a very popular theme, One Dark Pro, where basically everything is highlighted. The color for the brackets is different, so it might be a slightly modified version or it might be a different theme, but you can very clearly see what they are talking about here. Another example is this synthwave theme, basically the same as One Dark Pro, just with a different set of colors. And I kinda have to mention it. I always have to include a jab. Grovebox. Grovebox is less Christmas lights diarrhea and just regular diarrhea. Now, nothing I say in this video and nothing in the blog post is saying you're not allowed to like these. You're not allowed to use these. If this is what you like, if this is what you want to use, that's totally fine. It is your computer. It is your environment. Do whatever you want. However, there might be a better way. If everything is highlighted, nothing stands out. Your eye adapts and considers it a new norm. Everything is bright and shiny, and instead of getting separated, it all blends together. So here is a quick test. Try to find the function definition here. The thing you probably found was the comment. You probably didn't jump to this. You probably jumped to the gray bit because this is the only part that is not colorful. And how often do people forget to comment their functions? I've looked at quite a bit of open source code. And the answer is, a lot more than I would like to admit. And you might have found this easy, but compare this to the second one. Where is the function? Your eye is immediately drawn to the colorful objects. So we see blue, blue, yellow, blue. Oh, here it is. And this is an extreme example. This is not what the author is suggesting you actually go and use, but it does prove a point. When there is less color, it is easier to spot the color. When everything is colorful, nothing stands out. You have to make decisions. What is more important? What is less? What should stand out, what shouldn't. Highlighting everything is like assigning top priority to every task in Linear. I assume this is some task management application. It only works if most tasks have lesser priorities. And importantly here, nothing the author is saying is a unique idea. There are themes out there that already make use of these concepts. The issue is themes like One Dark Pro are incredibly popular. There are two main use cases you want your color theme to address. Look at something and tell what it is by the color. Of course, you can read the text and work out what it is, but the point of the syntax highlighting is to eliminate the reading when you're trying to find a certain thing. You shouldn't have to read everything to try to find a function definition or a constant or whatever specific kind of element you're looking for. And two, search for something. You want to know what to look for. Which color? One is a direct index lookup, color to type of thing. Two is a reverse lookup, type of thing to color. And the truth is, most people don't do these lookups at all. They might think they do, but in reality, they don't. Let me illustrate a point. Here we have two blocks of text. So this is the before, and this is the after. What changed between these two blocks of text? If you can't tell me immediately, there is a problem with the theme. And the answer is the misspelling of return. Here it's correct, and in the after it is returnra. Here is another test. Close your eyes and try to remember what color your color theme uses for class names. If you have a more minimal, more sensible use of color theme, you might actually know. But it's also possible you have four different colors in your head right now. It might give you comfort, as in, I feel safe if it's highlighted, it's probably code, but you can't use it as a tool. It is not a functional theme. It doesn't help you. What's the solution? Have an absolute minimum number of colors, so little that they all fit in your head at once. For example, the author's color theme, Alabaster, only uses four: green for strings, purple for constants, yellow for comments, and light blue for top level definitions. Now, personally, I think there's room for at least one more color, maybe two more, but anything more than that, you're not gonna have any idea what things are coloring what. Especially so with these themes where it's less about the color providing context and you knowing what that color is, and it's more about it looking pretty, where instead of it being different colors, it'll be different shades of the same color. So, oh, this one is pink, and this one is lightish red, and this one is magenta, but you sometimes decide on different days that it's actually maybe this one's pink, and use different colors, basically. And I was able to type it all from memory too. This minimalism allows me to actually do lookups. If I'm looking for a string, I know it'll be green. If I'm looking for something yellow, I know it's a comment. If you swapped green and purple in my editor, it'll be a catastrophe. If somebody swapped colors in yours, would you even notice? I don't think you would notice directly, but if you code enough, you'll probably feel that something is wrong. Something feels out of place. You won't be able to put your finger on it, but you know that something's not right. So what should you highlight? Remember, we want highlights to stand out. That's why I don't highlight variables or function calls. They are everywhere. Your code is probably 75% variable names and function calls. I do highlight constants, numbers, and strings. These are usually used more sparingly and often are reference points. A lot of logic paths start from constants. Top-level definitions are another good idea. They give you an idea of a structure quickly. Punctuation. It helps to separate names from syntax a little bit, and you care about names first, especially when quickly scanning code. Now, I don't agree with this final paragraph. Please, please don't highlight language keywords. Class, function, if, else, stuff like this. You rarely look for them. Where's that if is a valid question. But you'll be looking not at the if keyword, but at the condition after it. The condition is the important distinguishing part. The keyword is not. The reason I disagree with this is I often am searching for that keyword. I am searching for if. I am searching for else. I am searching for func or whatever the language happens to use as a function definition. For me, that is important syntax. I understand if that's not the way that you browse your code, in which case, don't color it. But this is the one part I disagree with the author on. Comments are important. The tradition of using gray for comments comes from the times when people were paid by line. If you use something like this, which honestly I'd be surprised if you even see code being commented like this, usually unless there's like an automatic document generator, you're never gonna see anyone doing this, especially in open source code. Corpo code, yeah, that's a whole different story. And of course, for code like this, you probably don't even want to see it anyway, and most code editors let you collapse for languages like Java because this is garbage and is literally just here to be read by the machine. Very rarely do you actually look at this and get any useful information out of it. Usually, your editor will actually parse this information for you and tell you the parameters that can be used with that function. But for good comments, the situation is opposite. Good comments add to the code, they explain something that couldn't be expressed directly. They are important. With that being said, comments should be highlighted, not hidden away. Use bold colors, draw attention to them, don't shy away. If somebody took the time to tell you something, then you want to read it. Usually. Again, this is about good comments. There are plenty of comments that are just left in code, but it's like, I'll fix this later, this is stupid, not my problem, fuck off, all this good stuff. Light or dark? Most developers prefer dark. This is a pretty settled question at this point. There is still that 30% that like light, and the author is one of them. The problem with light themes, though, is with the way that people normally make them, they inherently have to look bad. So this is a normal dark theme, and this is a normal light theme. The level of contrast between the colors is considerably lower, because if you make these colors too bright, they start blending in with the background and become hard to read. If you make them too dark, well, they all start blending together because they don't have much contrast now. Basically, in the dark part of the spectrum, you just get fewer colors to play with. There's no dark yellow, that's brown, or good-looking dark teal. Nothing can be done here. There are no magic colors hiding somewhere that have both good contrast on a white background and look good at the same time. By choosing a light theme, you are dooming yourself to a very limited, bad-looking, barely distinguishable set of dark colors. So it makes sense that dark themes do look better, or rather, light themes can't look good. This is science. However, you can take ideas from UI design and bring them into styling your code. And a lot of people don't do this, but they probably should. Using background colors. So, first line has nice colors, but the contrast is too low, letters become hard to read. The second one has good contrast, but you can barely see the colors. The last one, though, high contrast and clean, vibrant colors, lighter colors are readable even on a white background since they fill a lot more area. Text is the same brightness as in the second example, yet it gives the impression of clearer color. It's all upside really. This is something that more light themes should be doing. And UI designers understand this, and that's why they design buttons the way they do and use color with the buttons the way they do. This makes the color stand out vastly more than just having the text by itself. Sadly though, not every editor supports this, so your mileage may vary. But you don't just have to use color, you can also use typography. Here's an example with no syntax highlighting, but it does use bolds, and it does use italics, and this makes it considerably more readable. And of course, you don't just have to use one or the other. You can use bolds and italics, and also syntax highlighting, and get even better clarity. The myth of number-based perfection. Some themes pay too much attention to be scientifically uniform. All colors have the exact lightness, and hues are distributed evenly on a circle. This could be nice to know if you have OCR, but in practice, it doesn't work as well as it sounds. None of these colors really stand out. Yes, it might be a nice looking theme, but none of the colors pop, and that's kind of the point, but at the same time, that kind of defeats the purpose of having syntax highlighting. The purpose is that things pop out. Now, with all of this being said, let's design a color theme together. And we're gonna start from that really bright, annoying theme from earlier. And the first step is doing the one thing that I wouldn't do, and that's removing highlighting from any language keywords and reintroducing a base text color. Now, I do agree reintroducing a base text color is a good thing, but I would keep these keywords highlighted. That's just me. And with the end result, you'll see why that still would work. And next, we remove color from variable usage. And even now, it's vastly better than it was. And then from function and method invocation. You might notice that volume changes here. This is not a function or a method invocation. This should have been changed up here. This, like, variable would technically be included in fields, but the author must have forgot to do so and had to remember to do it in the next picture. But notice that we've kept variable declarations. It's technically a constant in this case, but the declaration of this thing that we are keeping around. These are not as ubiquitous and help you quickly answer a common question, where does this thing come from? Next, let's tone down the punctuation. So right here, it's like yellow and purple. Let's just make it all gray. However, if you find punctuation not really that important and you want it to just blend in with the background, you could just make it the base text color as well, and that also works. Next, comments are important, so make sure those are being highlighted. And we don't use red here because usually red is being used by the editor as like, hey, there's an error here. So you don't want your errors to blend in with anything that you're highlighting. And there's still one too many colors. There's no reason for these numbers and these strings to be different. So just unify them on a singular color. Finally, let's rotate the colors a bit. We want to respect nesting logic. So function declaration should be brighter, yellow, then variable declarations, blue. Frankly, I could do without this step. It doesn't really matter to me. As long as the colors are distinguished from each other, I think that makes the most sense. Yes, you could argue color theory makes sense to do here as well. For me, it's the least of my concerns. And look at what we have and compare this to where we started. I do still think highlighting language keywords could work here, and this wouldn't be too much color. But this is vastly more usable than whatever this was. But what do you think? Do you agree? Do you think this is a better theme? Do you prefer something like this? Do you want something somewhere in the middle? Or do you even care? Do you use syntax highlighting? Are you one of these people that writes C code with no highlighting in Vim with no help whatsoever? If you are, I know who you are and you're probably commenting from an alt. Anyway, if you liked the video, go like the video. If you want to go subscribe as well. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Stanley Berape, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and look at the colors.